was pretty darn good. Thanks, Roger and Kay, for doing that. It's just a lot of fun. All you do is follow the leader. It's real easy. Okay, next one is going to be a one-step. Remember in the dance class? We did a one-step. This is going to cook. It's going to go fast. So, here we go. We'll meet you at the end. It wasn't planned that way, but actually,
it's
If you can't hear some of the instruments or some are too loud, too soft, let us know. We can't tell from out there. Clarence is a little, our clarinet player is a little bit handicapped because it's hard to compare a reed instrument for volume to a brass instrument. But anyway, he's surrounded by brass, so he's got his work cut out for him. But he's a real trooper, so I know he can handle it. Okay, it's waltz time. Now we're going to do our best to keep the tempo not too fast. It's really sometimes hard to take these down where the waltzing it can be done easier. So anyway, this is after the ball.
Thank you.
Okay, we practice the cakewalk during the dance classes. We're going to take this a little bit faster so it's appropriate cakewalk tempo. But remember, in case you forgot, your basic step, if you wish to do this, is touch, step, touch, step. And then use your imagination from there. Anyway, this is a number that has a high degree association with cakewalk dancing called Atta Georgia Camp Meeting.
Wave.
Yeah, look at those cakewalkers out there. Loved it. So. Glad you're participating. You know, we don't have a cake to award for the prize. I guess we'll have to be thinking further ahead on that. So, anyway, we're going to... The next one will be a slower, classical, ragtime piece done in foxtrot tempo. Two slows, four quicks. So this will be the proper one if you want to practice that. This is the Cascades by Scott Joplin. I saw couple of Foxtrotters out there. By the way, there's no limit to, you know, more room for more than just one couple on the dance floor. So make sure you take advantage of it. There's lots and lots of space out here. Called the ragtime dance, which we are going to do right now. And we have to have a little conference here, you know.
John, what's the trombone player's name?
Paul Bryson.
Paul. Bryce.
Bride.
B-R-I-D.
S-O-N.
Okay, it's time for a tango. All right? We practice it briefly. We're going to do two more, this one and one more, and then we're going to take a little pause. Okay? Tango's coming up. Cuba Nola. Done during the rag era. Cuba Nola.
Lindquist, thank you. Thank you.
will see you in just a very short time here. 15, 20 minute break, and then we'll be right back.
Don.
Hey, Don.
Don, have him
sit out on the floor. Can't see you.
Here, we really appreciate it. We're going to do a Foxtrot Tempo the one slower end of the scale. A well-known Scott Dotner rag, I heard it this afternoon, but we have it as a band arrangement here, The Chrysanthemum by Scott Joplin.
Thank you.
Again, that was The Chrysanthemum by Scott Joplin. Okay, we're going to do another cakewalk. This will be a little bit slower, so as you slow down for the evening, you can handle it maybe a little bit better. Called the Swipesy Cakewalk.
Okay.
Okay, we're going to do... the two-step tempo, foxtrot if you wish, or whatever step you want to do. By the way, there's room for several more couples on the dance floor. So those couples way in the back, you know, you can work your way up here. There's lots of floor space, I see, right down here in front of us. Okay, we're going to do, published way back in 1904, The Favorite by Scott Joplin. I don't know if it was his favorite, but this is what he called it. Here we go. Thank you. Okay. We're going to play another one here before we take a little pause in the action. This is a one step called Red Wing. Red Wing. Here we go. Quantity that counts, it's the quality. So here we go, we're back shortly.